that's.
It's the Yulisu Rosenstern Computer Internet Show.
Sally was a 15-year-old girl from Nebraska.
Hello, Lovelace. I am Gilda Sue Rosenstern. Yeah, I'm going to start off with a poem that I wrote. It's called, it's a sort of a love poem, I think. I'm not real sure yet. It's not done. I've been working on it for 2 years. It's called, Oh, Monkey, My Monkey. Yeah, first, before I get started, though, y'all, I do want to apologize for not being quite myself. Yo, I'm having a little bit of what I love to call hair of the puppy dog. Because, you know, I think I'm still just a little bit tipsy from drinking Drambuie margarita pitchers last night with CNN's Nancy Grace. I know, Nancy Grace. I know what all of y'all are thinking. It's a huge coincidence because you're thinking, I remind you of Nancy Grace. Minus the law degree and the big TV network contract and the vitriolic self-righteous indignation. Well, you can only imagine my surprise when I walked into my favorite little restaurant here in town. It's called Bitch. Do y'all know it? Have y'all been there? You have been there, I can tell. Just by looking at you, you've been there. I recognize you. I know Wednesday night strip trivia. That's where I know you. Hi! Anyway, y'all was so surprised, and I walked into Bitch, and there she was. CNN's Nancy Grace in her cups. As they say. Now, y'all, I haven't been in Bitch for a whole week. I mean, I went down there last night to celebrate because y'all was celebrating my full recovery from some minor injuries I'd suffered in a recent car crash. Y'all was laid up in the bed for a whole week. I was following strict doctor's orders. Y'all was on a constant stream of muscle relaxers, Drambuie Cosmos, and Fox News. Well, the muscle relaxers were my idea, and the Drambuie were Gomez's idea, but yeah, I really don't believe that I could have gone by without them. I mean, have y'all ever been in a car crash? I mean, it's a jarring experience. Yeah, the whole thing just left me super thoughtful. Rural contemplative. Now it's just, I found that I was filled with musings of a philosophical nature, which is probably mostly due to the constant stream of Fox News commentary, also not prescribed by a medical professional. You know, I learned a whole lot lying up in the bed watching the TV for a whole week. I mean, what I learned is that we're in a pickle. I mean, maybe y'all don't know about this, maybe you do. But they're calling it an energy crisis. Now, at first, I really did believe that they were just talking about that lethargic feeling that you get when you're on a constant stream of muscle relaxers, Drambuie, and Fox News content. But no, y'all, they were talking about oil. Now, apparently, this is where we get our gasoline that we put into our cars, so we can drive around town looking for more gasoline to put in our cars. And you know, it's super expensive. And apparently we buy it from foreigners who hate America and hate our freedom to stay on a constant stream of muscle relaxers, Drambuie, and Fox News content. Now, there are some barflies down there, and bitch, you believe that they have an answer to this pickle. And what they say is that we should just drive less. But, you know, I mean, where in the world is that going to leave us? I mean, it didn't take a constant stream of muscle relaxers, Drambuie, and Fox News commentary to know that, you know, this country is founded on the love of the automobile. I mean, if It's our most popular religion. We sacrifice millions of virgins' titty every year. No, really, look at the news. I mean, children are killed in car crashes all the time. I lost my innocence years ago, so, you know, my injuries were minor. But, I mean, where would I be if it hadn't been for that strapless prom dress my babeshi begged me not to wear all those years ago? I mean, I'd be in a bigger pickle than I am right now. Anyway, it is something to ponder, for sure. But driving less is simply not the answer. Bitch, it's three whole blocks from my house, and y'all, I drink too much to walk that far. Anyway, like I said, I was there last night, and I was celebrating. And then I found myself playing quarters with CNN's Nancy Grace. Yeah. I will tell you, it was a wild night. I mean, CNN's Nancy Grace, sober, well, at least in there, is an angry, angry woman. And honest to goodness, she is just not the most popular girl at the party. So, y'all, when I walked in and I saw her there, she's just teetering on the edge of that bar stool and just not a friend in sight, kvetching about Anderson Cooper and Larry King, y'all. My heart just went out to her. And I decided I'd give her some much needed advice. You know, just one hometown girl made good to another. And I said, Nancy, chillax. That's what I said. And then I said, accentuate the positive for the love of Moses. And then I said, don't you think, CNN's Nancy Grace, that it would be better if you spend a little less time talking about all those things that you hate, like polygamists and cruise ships, and spend a little bit more time talking about those things that you love, like your twin babies or your wig collection, you know what? I have no idea how much sunk in, because she was stark raving drunk by the time I arrived. I mean, the last thing I remember was Wolf Blitzer showing up and lamenting how he was once again having to drag Nancy Grace out of bitch because nobody seemed to be able to drag the bitch out of Nancy Grace. Why was I up here talking? Oh, I was going to read you some poetry. I was going to read you, Oh Monkey, My Monkey. It's a love poem, I think. Y'all, it's a real long poem. I don't really believe I have time for this poem. I mean, it took me 2 years to write it. Until next time I come, I will read to you, Oh Monkey, My Monkey. And then I tell you what, then I'll read two more because I believe I'll have them done. I'll read Ode to Cyclobenzaprine. And then I'll read my third one, which is almost done. It's called To Bleach or Not to Bleach. The Ballad of Proper Modern Cosmetic Anal Maintenance. So next time we'll get to that. I really appreciate y'all indulging me. This has been real, real fun. If you want to hear more of me speaking words, it's spoken word, you can look me up on the internet. I'm on the YouTube. You can just Google Gilda Sue and you'll find me everywhere. And I thank y'all so much for listening. You've been real cute. Bye now.
Buff, buff.